Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Mercury Models. We're not professional, but we get pleasing results. I hope you've been enjoying my weathering on my locomotives. I also enjoy model building, so I would like to start that branch of my channel also. And as I've shown in previous builds, I not too long ago did this American Sherman, and I would like to build a diorama with it. I've never built a diorama before, but I think it would be interesting to show this off on a diorama. So when I was at my hobby store a little bit ago, just looking at options, I found this on sale. It's a farm wall entrance by Mini Art. If you go to their website, it's miniart-models.com. They have a lot of nice pictures of models that have been built, and assembly guide, painting, catalog, all sorts of good stuff. So I encourage you to go check them out. So I think we could try this diorama stuff. Now the kit, the instructions are not very detailed, but as I mentioned, on their website they have a full assembly guide. It's not this particular kit that they have the assembly guide for, but they run through assembly procedures. So I don't know, be worth a shot. So all the parts are on this big chunk of plastic. Got our doors, hinges, handles, and then another section on the right there. So according to, get that out of the way, according to the website and the instructions, the way we remove this is by scoring with an awl. I'm going to use my hobby knife and then just snapping the extras off. So let's just give this a shot. I'm using a brand new blade, nice and sharp, and I am just scoring it right along the edge, and I'm going over it a couple times. I felt that it broke through a couple places already, so it seems to be working out pretty good. Just keep scoring, working our way down deeper. Okay. There we go. Got the edge. Now, of course, we'll have to clean it up. Not too hard. It wasn't very painful. Let's try this next piece, this edge right here. Now, I would not recommend doing this without using a sharp blade, for sure. And I can see this blade getting dull real quick doing this, so I might have to go through a couple blades. But that's okay. There we go. It's coming off pretty easy. All right, so I think to save time, I'm just going to do this off camera, and then we'll go over cleaning it up with some sanding sticks or sandpaper and start mating the two surfaces. So I will see you in 1 second. I got all the pieces removed from one section. A lot thinner than I expected it to be. So the first piece that I removed, I got a little crazy with it, so I had to, I believe it was one of these two, had to repair it already with Tamiya's thin cement. Just be careful if you were to do this kit, that these are pretty flimsy, but in general it was fairly easy and painless to remove them. Just keep scoring along the edges, then you can kind of work them out pretty easy. Now this is some pretty good styrene. I'm gonna keep the big pieces around just for some scrap. This is good stuff. For the pieces that have the detail edges here, I just cut along the side. I didn't worry about trying to get in really tight. I'll use a hobby knife to clean those up. And hobby knife here. One thing I did notice with these tight edges, when I was coming in real close on some of them, my hobby knife wanted to keep going through that, not around it, so be careful of that. That's one edge right there where it tried to crawl up. So just be careful. Okay. So that is one down. One to go. So I will be right back. Everything is separated. All on their own now. All my little piles of stuff over there. So these two surfaces are going to be mated. And it's stone, so we can't have any gaps. Well, on the website it recommends using flat sanding paper. Well, all I have is 220 grit drywall sanding paper. I know, it's kind of redneck, but using the flat surfaces of my cutting mat, just hold it and sand it flat. It makes a horrendous noise because it's thin and it's hollow, so I'm not gonna do it on camera because it's very annoying. But just slowly sand that down, check your surfaces, and get a good mating surface. Now on the flashing that I didn't cut very well, I'm going to take my sanding stick and sand those edges nice and smooth. I have the darker blue is coarse and the lighter blue is a fine. So I'm just going to sand all those edges nice and smooth. Start with the coarse, finish with the fine. And get all those edges nice and cleaned up. Now this is stone, remember, so can't have any seams in stone. It's all one big piece, and they covered it with a mortar. So I guess there's seams in stone, but not on the mortar, especially where the two are joining. So I will get busy with all that. Couple things I've noticed already is in some of the corners, the pour was really thin. Kind of see in that corner right there how it's already popped through, and I just tried to clean it up with a sanding stick. So you got to be careful of those. We'll have to fix those with some putty. But when we go together, it's even when it's together, it's not very sturdy. So I was going to use some of my clamps here to try and hold it, but that just squeezes too hard. So I think what I'll do is I'm going to get some Tamiya tape here. Get a couple pieces ready and we'll just try and tape it in place, and we'll glue it just in kind of glue it in parts. And get it as lined up as possible. It's really flimsy. to me, it uses a capillary action to pull the glue into the seam, and then it melts the plastic. And once it's done melting, it dries and forms a glue joint that's basically just one piece of plastic. It's really good stuff. Keep going right around the edge here. Probably hear that train going by. Live just a couple blocks from the tracks, and if the wind is just right, excuse me, you can hear those trains really well. Give it a little squish. And to me, Tamiya sets pretty quick. Doesn't completely dry, but it sets. And that train again. Wind is blowing that sound right into my window. Keep working it around, make sure that your edge is all nice and lined up. There we go. One side of our arch is glued. Lines are not too bad. Got a gap right here on the bottom, but that's the bottom. It's going to be on the ground, so not too bad. seen that, wouldn't you? So you gotta yell. Yell at me. Tell me it's not your shot. That's gonna be the hardest thing for me, I think, with this YouTube, is you start getting focused on what you're doing and have all the camera and the light arms and everything in the way, and just start slowly focusing on what you're doing, and next thing you know, everyone's yelling at you, hey, we can't see. So apologize. Try and keep you guys in the shot as much as I can, but I can't promise everything. To pause the video and keep going around, and then we'll come back when it's set and take a look and see how it's doing. I'll see you in a minute. So our archway is drying. Just let that, we'll give it an hour probably to dry, but it's dry to the touch, just to give it a little bit extra drying time. While I wait for it to dry, I'm working on these two halves, and on this end it's going to be the deteriorated rock wall here, and it is really tough trying to trim that, so make sure you take your time trimming that edge. Now you can tell it's not perfect. I'm gonna get it close, and then when I get the two halves glued together, then I will sand it and touch it up some more. But while I'm doing that, I'm gonna do my first blade change. Brand new blade. And be careful, these are sharp, they're razors, so be very careful when you're changing your blades. That's your semi pro tip of the day. And what I'm doing is just trimming it back just a little bit at a time, trying to get to the contours of those bricks as best I can. So, getting it kind of close, but like I said, we'll get it close, we'll get them glued together, let the glue dry, and then we'll make it a little bit more, we'll clean it up. So, okay, well, see you in a little bit.